to go to work. Oh, y'all didn't say nothing to me. Read.
Then Peter said unto them,
repent.
And be baptized.
Every one of you.
In the name of Jesus Christ.
For the remission of sins.
And ye shall receive
the gift of the Holy Ghost. Well, I can prove mine.
Why did they tell me that Jesus' name baptism was the only one?
That there was no other baptism in the scriptures.
And I could not. The devil wanted me to go and fight with my parents and with those that baptized in Jesus' name. Because they said that the Father, Son, and Holy Ghost baptism did not work. And it wasn't according to the scriptures. But I just read it. Lord, who have believed our report? And to whom is the arm of the Lord revealed? And when I begin to look at it, and I begin to listen, I begin to understand that the baptism, Father, Son, and Holy Ghost was not what God said.
Well,
he said, go ye therefore and teach all nations, baptizing them in the name.
Yes, sir.
Come on now.
Not Father, Son, and Holy Ghost.
Yeah.
But in the name.
Yeah.
And I found the Eusebius who wrote in 200 A.D. said, go ye therefore, as Jesus said it, and teach all nations, making disciples in my name. Well, where did Father, Son, and Holy Ghost come from? Lord have mercy. That sounds like a trinity. I didn't know how blessed I was. I didn't understand that when I went to church, I was going to find out what the truth was. Shut my mouth. Went into the house of the Lord. And as the angel said, Lord have mercy. In the 73rd Psalms, when I went into the house of the Lord, then saw I there, therein, they walked in slippery places. Help me, Jesus. I want to tell you. Lord have mercy.
Let me find it because
I don't want you to think I made up a story. 73 Psalm.
Mm-hmm.
17th verse. Read.
Until I went into the sanctuary,
of God.
Then understood I therein.
What are you talking about, Elder Hoke? I thought surely they were going to be saved like I am when I found Matthew 28:19. But God began to show me that they were none of his. That's not what was supposed to be in the Bible. But at the same time, I found out that with a little study and a little understanding and putting my English together, as I had been taught at Pershing High School.
All right.
Glory, hallelujah. The subject of the verse in Matthew 28:19 was the name.
Yes.
The name was the subject. Glory, hallelujah. And the pronoun, Lord have mercy, which was used in the place of a name. Lord have mercy. It was not the name. It was used in place of a name. I had to find out what was the pronoun's name. So it says the name of the Father. Glory, hallelujah. What? Who is the Father? Glory, hallelujah.
Come on.
I found out that God is the Father. I got to quit. God is the Father. Glory, hallelujah. So his name must be Jehovah. And said, that was of the Son. And I knew the Son's name. It was Jesus. Then to find out what is the Holy Ghost's name. So I went to 14:26 of John. Glory, hallelujah. The Holy Ghost was coming in the name of Jesus. Lord have mercy. Jesus said in Matthew, not Jesus, but Gabriel, the archangel, while Jesus was in the womb, said his name shall be called Jesus. Matthew 1:21. Glory, hallelujah. His name shall be called Jesus, for he shall save his people from their sin. Lord have mercy. Glory, hallelujah. Then I had to go and find John 5:43, what Jesus said. I am come in my Father's name. Father was not God's name, but Jesus is the Father's name. Son is not his name, but his name is Jesus. And the Holy Ghost, his name is Jesus. So all I had to do was to be baptized in the name of Jesus. Because Acts 4:12 said neither is there salvation in any other, for there's none other name under heaven given among men whereby we must be saved.
Hallelujah.
I want you to understand.
Yes, sir.
I didn't know how blessed I was. I didn't know that coming to church would get me to know who God really is. Church is not my pastime anymore. It's my life. In church, I found the plan of salvation. I don't go to church just to get out. You see, I'd have night service. But you won't come. Because Sunday morning good enough for you. You see, when I was working in the drugstore, I could not go to Sunday morning service. Because I worked from 12 until 4 on Sunday morning. But Sunday night, service started, at 7:30. And so I went to church every Sunday night. Nobody made me go. My mother said I had to go to church in her, I was in her house every Sunday morning. Well, this was Sunday night. Glory, hallelujah. I didn't know how blessed I was. You might be wondering why she keeps saying that. Because I didn't know why I was going to church. I didn't know why I loved church. I didn't know why I was going there. Because I don't want to be no preacher. The only thing I knew, I didn't want to go to hell. Glory, hallelujah. I did not want to go to hell. I didn't want to go to hell so bad. It didn't matter what it took. If I left my lungs on the altar, so be it. I'm going to get the Holy Ghost.
Yes, yes.
Glory, hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
I was 15 years old. I carried. Till my throat was sore. I didn't just say hallelujah. But I was reaching out to God.
Yes,
I didn't know how blessed I was. Glory, hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Lord, who hath believed our report, and to whom is the arm of the Lord revealed? Everybody going to church this morning, and there's millions of them. Turn Lord have mercy, that man to come on at 7:30 in the morning, Joel Osteen. Turn Joel Osteen on. Channel 4. 7:30. You just want to go to church? Spend your half hour with Joel Osteen. If that won't do, you like a black preacher? Find T.D. Jakes. Spend a half hour with him. Find these preachers on radio. Oliver Green, Jimmy Swaggart, the crying preacher.
Thank you.
Hate to see a man always crying.
Right.
Man's supposed to be strong.
Right.
Even if you did do wrong, you can let some tears run. Like a strong man. Man that can stand up. Man that can face the music. Can't be crying all the time. You don't even want to see a woman that's always crying and whining.
Amen.
Get tired of that.
That's
right. You want somebody to talk to you. You got a problem. You got a problem. But you ain't got to cry about it.
Right.
I didn't know how blessed I was. God bless me to find the truth. If you want to just go to church, Apostolic Church of Jesus is not the place for you.
Right.
But if you want to know the truth,
yes, sir.
If you want to get to know who Jesus is,
yes, Lord.
If you want to know what it takes to be saved,
hallelujah.
This is the place.
Amen.
If you just want to fill your couple of hours in the house of the Lord, because they tell you we're only going to be 45 minutes, and you'll be out. And you flock there. And you don't even know what you got. When you leave, you don't even know why you were there. But you leave all your money. But what the truth is, you have to squeeze it. God gave it to you. You're not careful, God take it away from you. Haul it if you want to. God can take it. He gave it.
All right.
You think your job is secure?
Not so.
You think you're secure on your job?
So.
God can take it.
Come on.
Tell me you can't do something. You do whatever you want to do. Anything you want to do. And you think you got the strength to do it, you'll do it. But let me tell you something. Isaiah asked the question, who hath believed our report?
You know, I get upset sometimes when I'm sitting down thinking. I said, why can't these people understand what I'm saying? Why do they think I'm fighting them? Why do they think I'm attacking them, Lord? Don't they want to be saved? Don't they want understanding? Do they just want to say, I went to church and that's it? Lord, go ahead and believe what I've had to tell them. Why do they refuse to do what you said do? I'm trying to think of the scripture that come to my mind. He says, tell them, but they will not do it. They're not going to listen. He says, go tell them. You know, the preacher gets upset. That's how come Isaiah asked the question, Lord, who believed thy report? Moses said, these stiff-necked people, these rebels, they make me sick. Moses said, here you brought them across the Red Sea. You set them on the other side. They saw Pharaoh's army drowning. And they still don't believe. They don't believe nothing that you have to say. I'm blessed. I'm blessed. I didn't know I was blessed. But God began to show me that I didn't have to duck my head. Yeah, I'm saved and I'm sanctified.
Hallelujah.
Glory, hallelujah.
Thank you.
I know who Jesus is. I ain't just going to church, but I'm in church.
Amen. Hallelujah.
My motive for going to church, I want to learn more about Jesus.
Yeah.
But you're the pastor. You already know. See, that's where you're stupid, huh? Excuse me. Because while I'm teaching, God does some revealing. God opens up the way. And I realize my shortcomings. I realize my fault. Glory, hallelujah. I'm going to quit. Psalm 73 again. I want you to read the 14th verse. No, read the 13th verse.
Verily I have cleansed my heart in vain.
Asaph said, verily I have cleansed my heart in vain. And wash my hands in innocency. I've done it. I've tried to be as clear as I can, and they still don't listen, Lord. Read. 14.
For all the day long
have I been plagued, and chastened every morning.
If I say,
I will speak thus.
Behold,
I should offend against the generation of thy children. You know, Lord, they're not listening. They're very offended. And they look at you. And they tell you, who do you think you're talking to? Who do you think you're preaching to? They're offended. They want a preacher that will cause them to shout. They want a preacher to tell them everything is going to be all right. They want a preacher that won't tell them what's wrong.
They want to believe that they already said. Read.
When I thought to know this,
it was too painful for me. It was rough to understand that they don't even want to hear it. Of course they want to hear it. Lord, since you're calling me to preach, I want to tell them the truth. I want to tell them the truth. Even if it hurt me, Lord, I want to tell them the truth. Read.
Until I went into the sanctuary
of God,
then understood I therein.
Now, that's a terrible situation. When I get in God's word and I sit to teach and I begin to allow God to direct me in the word, the word then becomes offensive. Make people mad at you. They say, I ain't going to be back here next time. I ain't coming back this way. That's why I don't go to church. They always preaching that everybody going to hell over there. Read. Until I went into the sanctuary.
Yes, Lord.
Of God.
Then understood I therein.
Now listen to what Asaph said. Read.
Surely thou didst set them
in slippery places. They don't even know it. Read.
Thou castest them down into destruction.
Read.
How are they brought into desolation? As in a moment. They are utterly consumed with terrors.
I want you to understand this. I'm going to stop there. I want you to understand this. That when Asaph spoke, he was not speaking to someone outside the church. Israel was the church of that day. The whole of Israel was the church. And Asaph was speaking to the church that they didn't believe and that they were in slippery places. Last story, young man was at St. Paul Church. We were at St. Paul and it had rained. And it was just at the freezing point. And when I came down Hamilton Avenue, I knew that it was slippery. So I had to drive very carefully because you couldn't see the ice. It was no snow. It was just what they call black ice. And as I went down Hamilton, I had to be very careful because even going slow and you hit the brake, you still feel sorry. The young man left church that night. Being a young driver, had his mother's car, jumped out on Hamilton, going home, couldn't see the ice. Started out down Hamilton Road. When I came, left behind him a few minutes behind him, he had wrecked. He didn't know he was in slippery places. You see, when you don't know that you're in a slippery place, that is very dangerous. That is very dangerous. Because you so stupidly will do things that you would normally do. Mm-hmm. Saints, who have believed our report, and to whom is the arm of the Lord revealed? God bless me. I'm not in this just because of my mama and daddy. Thank God that they taught me. But today, I'm in it because I know what I got. I know who Jesus is. He has blessed me. He has truly kept me. And so I owe him. He doesn't owe me. He blessed me. Now I owe to him. And I say, I can't give to him. Lord, I can't give you my time. I got to work. I have to go to work. Let me tell you something, saints. Wake up to salvation. Don't let the devil put you in slippery places.
Yes, sir.
Don't let the devil lead you down Primrose Lane, because it's slippery.
Yes, sir.
The Lord is good.
Yes,
he is. I know I've gone longer than I intended. But I trust that you got to understand something that I had to say. Lord, who hath believed our report? Who hath believed what we had to say today, Lord? And to whom is the arm of the Lord revealed? Who has come to know you and realize that they need to draw closer to you? Now is the time. Now is the time. If you want to be saved, you got to do it God's way. Not the way that mama did it. Not the way that daddy did it. Come on now. You can't do it that way. You can't do it the way grandma and grandpa did. But you got to do it like the Bible said do it. I might have gotten baptized when I was 9 years old because I was brought up in the Apostolic Church. When I got older, then I realized that I got the right baptism. I was blessed. I didn't even know I was blessed. But I want you to know today, there's only one Lord, one faith, and one baptism. Jesus is the only one that can save. It is his blood that was shed on Calvary. God has made preparations for you to be saved. He says, arise and be baptized. Wash away thy sin, calling on the name of the Lord. Acts 22:16. We got clothing for men, women, and children. The water is prepared. We have someone to baptize you in the name of Jesus. If you're here today, will you come? All things are ready. All things are ready. God has talked to you. I don't know why he let me stand this long, but he allowed me. He has sent his word. Are you here today? Did you listen? Did you hear anything that would help you? Did you hear anything that will help you turn your life around? All things are ready. There's only one way to be saved. That's in the name of Jesus. We see that there's none coming. I can't even see anybody making that move at the present time. But I want you to know, if you're here today, God spoke to you. truly spoke to you. And you feel he said something to you. That you need to get straight with him. You ought to stand up right now. It's time for you to receive prayer. Don't wait till everybody else come. You come. You come. Don't wait for somebody else. Don't wait till the whole church stand and then you say, well, now I can go. They won't see me. Then I understand that those that said do not have a problem. They have it already right with God. Well, you said, oh, hold on. Well, if you just set me to hide, if you know you got a problem, you ought to be the first one out of your seat. You ought to be the first one to come. The man at the pool. Jesus asking, would you be made whole? He said, Lord, before I can get there, somebody else steps in. And the angel leaves before I can step in. Jesus said, I didn't ask you that. He said, would you be made whole? And he said, yea, Lord. Jesus said, take up your bed and walk. You see, it pays to let God know you got a problem. It pays to get your life right. I want you to bow your head. Get your problem in your heart, in your mind. Get your problem in the forefront. Get your mind to where you will receive what God has to say to you. And he'll say, he knows what's in your heart. I don't know, but God knows. Father, in thy name, in thy precious name, thou art God alone. There's no God other than thee. And thou knowest the heart of each one that has come to the altar. You know their purpose, and you know the desire. You know the purpose for which they stand. In your precious name, we need the power of your spirit this morning. We need the power of your love in Apostolic Church of Jesus. Touch every soul. Touch every soul. They came because they got a problem. Touch every soul that is desiring a closer walk with you. Bless this morning, Lord. Move every obstacle. Move every obstacle, Lord. Lord, don't move the obstacle. I take it back, Lord. Don't move the obstacle. Help them to go around it. Help them to go around the obstacle. Help them to work their way around it. Help them to go through it. Let your blood prevail. Let your spirit abide. Touch their hearts. If it's true, Lord, give them what they need. Bless the day, Lord. Every soul that stands before this altar, bless them right now. In thy mighty name, give them what they need. Show them the way you would have them go. Bless them with understanding. Give them knowledge. Draw nigh thee. Let thy blessings flow in this hour, Lord. And help us, Lord, to continue to do your will and to follow after thee. In Jesus' name. Amen. You may return, Jesus. We thank God. I didn't mean to take so long. I hardly had anything before I stood up. All I had was Isaiah, John, and Romans. But God gave me what he wanted to say. I spoke it by the will of God. If it hurt you, I'm sorry. But I'd do it again. I'll do it again. If the Lord tells me. Your soul is on the line. I got to protect my soul. You don't understand. Every preacher that stands in the pulpit has got to give an account. I don't care if he's a false preacher or not. He's got to give an account. It's going to be bad for a preacher in hell. It's going to be bad. It's going to be bad for any saint who heard the word of God and then refused to obey it. It's going to be a bad situation in hell, y'all. But you got to believe that. I might be just telling you that to scare you. I might just be saying that to make you do what you don't want to do. But you better find out for yourself. You better search the scriptures. For in them ye think ye have eternal life. Come on, Lee, and we're going to prepare to receive offering. You might not want to give any offering after I preach.